thank you for a great introduction. And C described in the an abstract for my presentation. So now let's get started. And I am Satoshi Tagomori and came from Japan, Tokyo, Japan. And then I am an author of some open source software, like open source software and the committer of FluentD project and the Norikra project. And then now, and I am a maintainer of MessageBack Ruby project. And MessageBack Ruby project, MessageBack Ruby gem is now including and JRuby implementation in one gem. My most recent open source contribution is a Docker logging driver for FluentD, and which transfers the Docker logs into FluentD process directory, and it will be released in Docker with Docker version 1.8. And my day job is I'm working for Treasure Data Inc., and which is a data process software as a service company for data processing service, and which is placed on Mountain View headquarters and have a Tokyo branch. I'm working it as the Tokyo branch, and at first hand, we are hiring. So, and if you are interested in our company, and please contact me or visit this URL. Okay, and data processing world. And in data processing world, is dominated by him. So, and by Java. So, and there's many open source middleware and software, and like Hadoop, Spark, Tez, Spring, Storm, Kafka, Hypig, Drill, Imperant, Preston, and then they have a very curious logo characters. But, almost all of these are written in Java and some of other languages and runs on JVM, like in Scala or Clojure, or very little written in C++. But that is the reason. Why these softwares are written in Java is these software requires and very many CPU cores and large memory space and high rate disk IOs. And so, For high throughput data processing, JVM has many good features and many good improvements for this and this perspective. And we also must provide the compatibility for Hadoop, YAN, or MapReduce, or HDFS APIs. And that is very required by almost all of data processing users and system programmers. That is why we must use in Java or JVM languages and for data processing softwares. So now I will talk about two open source software using Java and JRuby named as Norikra and Embulk. And these are written, and Norikra is written by, Norikra is originally written by me, and Embulk is originally written by Sadayuki Furuhashi, who is also original author of MessageBack, and the chief architect of Treasure Data. Now, Norikra. Norikra is an open source software, server software written in JRuby, runs on JVM and licensed under the GPL v2. And Norikra is also distributed on RubyGems.org, so and you can install gem by this command, gem install Norikra, of course, and if you are using JRuby. So, and what Norikra does is very simple. And Norikra provides a feature to process SQL like this. But in this SQL have and very little extension and to express the data window size by dot win length underscore batch 10. So and this SQL Norikra processes this SQL for each 10 data like this. If input first data and arrived, and Norikra updates internal status by pass and sum of bytes. If this data have a status equal 200. Okay, then another data arrived, and this data have a different path from previous data. So this this SQL and update and this internal counter and by other with other record, and then and this the third data have and status 404. So this SQL it just ignore this data, and then so test data arrived. When tense data arrived, Norikra automatically flashes this internal status into output data by and three records ordered by sum of bytes descendant. So this is an almost all of Norikra does. It's very simple but very powerful because we can. We do not, we if we want if we want to process and the streaming data data arrived at as stream now we must write the Storm application or any other customized application, but we can write the process by SQL on Norikra. So anyway, and Norikra is written in JRuby and using the Java library named as Esper. So, and why I wrote Norikra in JRuby? JRuby is the most important point is productivity because I don't have not so many time for when I require the such system. So, I used JRuby, not Java. Not Java directory, and Esper is the third party Java library and provides in complex event processing, and the feature for SQL parser and executor. This is in the open source software licensed under GPL v2. So, and that is because that is the reason why Norikra is licensed under GPL v2. So anyway, and Norikra has a plugin feature, and as Ruby gems. So Norikra's plugin is packaged and released as Ruby gem, and the plugin system is for UDF and listener plugin. UDF and Norikra can with Norikra, and we can we can add in user defined functions and so. And user can write in any the function whatever you want and add it into Norikra. So, and then we can install and that gem that UDF we can publish that gem into RubyGems.org or install that gem file directory by gem command. And UDF plugins will be loaded into the Esper Java library. So, and UDF plugins and must be a Java class, and we can write in these UDF code in Java or JRuby, and JRuby code is compiled to Java. And listener plugin is the handler for output data of queries, and it will be written in JRuby, and also it is also can be installed by a gem command. Sorry. Okay, and Embulk. Embulk is an open source data bulk loader and plugin based and parallel bulk data loader and open source software licensed under Apache license version 2 and distributed as JAR or gem and both distributed as both in the JAR or Ruby gems. And plugins are distributed on RubyGems.org. And Embulk is Embulk is this and almost input and output are written in plugins, and almost as many other features are provided by plugins. But Embulk provides the very core feature like parallel execution or data validation, error recovery, deterministic behavior, or idempotent retrying. These features are very difficult to implement and ensure by plugins, because that is the reason why Embulk provides these core features. And we can add any other plugins for input and output and filters. So, and if we want to add another data source or data destination to our Embulk system, you can write one plugin to adding support for software or distributed systems or services, whatever you want. And almost all these features are provided by plugins and input plugin and output plugin and decoder encoder for gzip or any bgp2 or any other decoder and encoder is for compression or decryption or any others. And parser plugin and format plugin is for formats like CVS, JSON, PKF, and TSV or any other formats based on plain text files. And filter plugin and if we want to if you and add in the filter plugins to ignore any other invalid data or any others, and you can write and add and filter plugins. And executor plugin is very and highly and connected to Embulk, but there's an only executor plugin to execute this bulk loading on Hadoop MapReduce. Hadoop MapReduce executor can execute this whole process on and Hadoop distributed systems. Okay, and Embulk and Java. And Embulk core is written in Java because and mainly for performance. Original author Sadayuki Furuhashi is a kind of a performance freak, and I cannot against him. So Sada says that I will write Embulk in Java for performance, and I can only say okay, understood, and that's all. So, but anyway, and Embulk plugins are loaded and over API based on JRuby, and almost all and Embulk plugins at first almost all Embulk plugins are written in Java in JRuby, and now plugin features are were added, and these are supported. These are supposed to write plugins in Java. So, and you can choose which language you write in plugins in JRuby for early release and Java for performance. This is the input plugin in JRuby, and it is very short and simple Ruby code, and we can like, and if you want to add new data source or data destination, and you should write just this code, and very very short and simple code. And anyway. And plugin management of Norikra and Embulk. And Norikra has an SPI instance. SPI instance, and SPI is written in Java in base of all of Norikra stack. But Norikra's engine and plugin management are written in JRuby. And the whole all of these part are written in JRuby. And Norikra supports an UDF writing in both of Java and JRuby, and recent plugins are for JRuby, only JRuby. And Embulk is almost Embark core is written in Java, but a plugin management system layer is written in Java and JRuby, and all plugins are loaded over that layer using JRuby. And some the plugin systems which the many users and many plugin authors want to write plugins which the many plugin authors and users want to write are supported to write in JRuby, like an input plugin, output plugin, filter plugin, parser plugin, and format plugin. And then decoder and encoder is and highly performance dependent, and not so many users want to write such plugins because there are not so many compression algorithms or encryption methods without GZIP or BZIP or and OpenSSL. Yes, so and it is only supported, but it is these plugins, the writing these plugins are supported in only Java and executed. Anyway, and the pluggable systems on JVM and Java API. So, and of course, we have an options to write as in other language like in Java or Scala or Clojure, and of course, including JRuby. So, and but and we want to have an the well designed and plugin system. So, the solving dependency of JAR files and Java packages is the real nightmare for and Maven Central is not so good distribution service, especially for plugin authors. Registering Maven Central is a bit hard rather than registering into the rubygem.org. So that is the reason why we are choosing JRuby on Java software and to make a well-designed plugin system and plugin systems. So and then plugin loader, and for plugin loader we can use the class loader with JRuby, but the class loader using class loader is also difficult and confusing for me and normal Ruby programmer. So and we are using just require to load the new Ruby code and Java code wrapped by JRuby code. That is very simple and understandable for almost all of plugin authors, including me. Okay, and I have some time for. Okay, and JRuby in Japan. So, JRuby, there's not so many users because Japan is the country for. Japan is a country which. The maths is living, and JRuby is a super major software in Japan, and I in Japan, and I have a JRuby committer coworker Nahi in Treasure Data. So that is the Treasure Data is a very good environment to write JRuby, but in fact, Treasure Data have. Two JRuby committer, so and that is the thing the thing and I can see everywhere in Japan. So, and many programmer and open source software used in Java, but then they transferred to Lite and Ruby in several or 10 years ago. But then now they are writing a Scala or Golang. I don't like and these languages, not so, but now JRuby is not so major in Japan, but I and Sadaki Furashi is living in Mountain View, but some of developer in Japanese Ruby community are starting to use JRuby. So and I am expecting that JRuby is getting major than ever. Okay, and that's his conclusion. So and please make your software pluggable and by making your software pluggable, makes an ecosystem and community around that open source software. So and I think that JRuby is the best solution for to do that. Thank you very much.